Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Top 10 Trends. Palaces. Look, if you're sitting in a palace, you've already won the game. You're just racking up the score. And they do rack up the score. There are crappy palaces, believe it or not. It's better than what I got, but it's still crappy in the scape of palaces. These are 10 of the world's largest palaces. I'm tired of saying palaces already.
And it's only gonna get worse.
Number 10, the Quirinal Palace. It's a historic building in Rome, Italy. One of the three current official residences of the President of the Italian Republic. It's located on the highest of seven hills of Rome. It's housed 30 popes, 4 kings, and 12 presidents of the Italian Republic. The palace extends for an area of 110,500 square meters and is absolutely massive. The White House of the United States is only 1/20th of its size. It also has a garden with an area of 40,000 square meters, give or take. 4 hectares. Somewhere hidden within the Quirinal's gardens lies the famous water organ built in 1999. It's based on the characteristics of a previous 19th century organ. The organ is fed by a waterfall with a jump of 18 meters and has a single keyboard of 41 notes. Under the gardens, through a trap door, one can reach the archaeological excavations that have unearthed the remains of the original temple to the god Quirinus of the Imperial Age. Just the ceilings in this place cost more money than anyone in my ancestry has ever spent in their entire lives and adjusting for inflation. And combined. Number 9, the Royal Palace of Madrid. The Royal Palace of Madrid is the official residence of the Spanish royal family, and it's obviously in Madrid, but it's used only for state ceremonies. King Felipe VI and the royal family do not live in the palace, choosing instead their more modest palace of Zarzuela on the outskirts of Madrid.
Ah, but that's our summer palace. We only spend weekends there.
The palace is owned by the Spanish state and administered by a public agency of the Ministry of the Presidency. On some days it's free to enter, but usually there's an admission fee of 11 euros to get into the palace. Rooms that are open to the public, of course. The palace is 135,000 square meters of floor space and contains, brace yourselves, seriously, 3,418 rooms. It's the largest royal palace in Europe by floor area. The interior of the palace is notable for its wealth of art and the use of many types of fine materials in the construction and decoration of its rooms. There are paintings by artists such as Caravaggio, Francisco de Goya, and Velazquez. Other collections of great historical and artistic importance preserved in the building include the Royal Armory of Madrid, porcelain, watches, furniture, silverware, and the world's only complete Stradivarius string quintet. Number 8, Malbork Castle. The castle of the Teutonic Order at Malbork, located in the Polish town of Malbork, is the largest castle in the world measured by land area. It was originally built by the Teutonic Knights in form of an Ortsenburg fortress. The town that grew around it was named Marienburg. The castle is an example of a medieval fortress and the world's largest brick castle. When the castle was founded in 1274 by the Teutonic Knights, they used it as their headquarters to defeat Polish enemies and rule their own northern Baltic territories. It was expanded several times to host the growing number of knights until their retreat to Königsberg in 1466. In 1466, both castle and town became a part of Royal Prussia, a province of Poland. It served as one of the several Polish royal residencies, fulfilling this function until the partitions of Poland in 1772. There was even a 3-year period where Swedish forces occupied the castle. Number 7, the Forbidden City. The Forbidden City is a palace complex in Beijing, China. The former Chinese imperial palace from the Ming Dynasty to the end of the Qing Dynasty, 1420 to 1912. It now houses the Palace Museum. The Forbidden City served as the home of emperors and their households, as well as the ceremonial and political center of the Chinese government for almost 500 years. The complex consists of 980 buildings and covers over 180 acres, coming in at 150,000 square meters. That's just the building. The enclosed area total is 720,000 square meters, making it the world's largest palace complex. It sees about 16 million visitors annually. The Forbidden City is a massive rectangle. A common myth states that at one time there were 9,999 rooms, including antechambers. But many surveys of the building's ruins state that this is not the case. The Forbidden City was designed to be the center of the ancient walled city of Beijing. It's enclosed in a larger walled area called the Imperial City. The Imperial City is enclosed by the Inner City. Inner, Imperial, Forbidden. Number 6, the Apostolic Palace. The Apostolic Palace is the official residence of the Pope of Rome, located in Vatican City. It's also known as Papal Palace, Palace of the Vatican, Vatican and Vatican Palace. The Vatican itself refers to the building as the Palace of Sixtus V in honor of the Pope Sixtus V. The building contains the papal apartments, various offices of the Catholic Church, and the Holy See, private and public chapels, Vatican museums, and the Vatican Library, including the Sistine Chapel, Raphael Rooms, and Borgia Apartment. In the 5th century, Pope Symmachus built a papal palace close to Old St. Peter's Basilica. This was eventually raised in 1447 by Pope Nicholas V to erect a new building, the current Apostolic Palace. The major additions and decorations of the palace are the work of the following popes for 150 years. Construction in the current version began under Pope Sixtus V, and its various intrinsic parts were completed by later successors, Urban VIII, Innocent XI, Clement VIII, and Pope Pius XI. It's absolutely massive, covering 162,000 square meters. And it's funny, because on Wikipedia it says the owner is the Pope. Like, the Pope just owns it. I bought it one day. I'm the Pope. Number 5, Istana Nirola Mon. Istana Nirola Mon is the official residence of the Sultan of Brunei and the seat of the Brunei government. The palace is located on a leafy riverside sprawl of hills on the banks of the Brunei River, near its capital city. The palace is often at the center of state occasions and royal hospitality. It's considered to be the world's largest private residence in terms of floor area, earning the title World's Largest Residential Palace, and with 200,000 square meters of space, you can see why. The title of World's Largest Palace is difficult to ascertain and controversial, as different countries use their own unique standard to claim their palace is the largest. Guinness World Records currently considered Istana Nirola Mon to hold the title as World's Largest Residential Palace. It's the largest single-family residence ever built. It contains 1,788 rooms, 257 bathrooms, a banquet hall that can be expanded to accommodate up to 5,000 guests, and a mosque accommodating 1,500 people. It also has a 110-car garage and an air conditioning stable for the Sultan's 200 polo ponies, as well as 5 swimming pools. Because of its massive size, they make use of 564 chandeliers, 51,000 light bulbs, 44 stairwells, and 18 elevators. Number 4, the Presidential Complex. The Presidential Palace, also known as the Presidential Complex, is the palace of the Republic of Turkey. It was formally inaugurated as the official residence of the president on October 29, 2014. The palace is referred to as Aksaray, meaning White Palace. In 2015, the Turkish Council found that the construction of the palace violated the law and ordered it to be vacated. However, the presidency has stated that the decision is ultra vires, meaning that the palace can't be vacated because it can't be open to judicial or parliamentary scrutiny due to its independence. Sounds loophole-y. The Presidential Palace compound is said to contain a top-secret special operations command and control center housed in a secure bunker. The center has a 143-screen visual command center which correlates data obtained from UAVs, CCTV, and 3G transmissions from all 81 provinces of Turkey. All data is archived in 2 special supercomputer servers to enable intelligence agencies to track back the paths of suspects. The Palace C4I system can target, track, and follow individuals based on biometrics and any 2D image of the target being uploaded into the system. Yay! It has 1,105 rooms, and the building cost was over $600 million. The monthly bill of this place is equivalent to the monthly salary of 363 minimum wage workers. That's dope. It covers an area of 300,000 meters squared, with additional guest houses, a botanical garden, and bunkers able to withstand nuclear, biological, and chemical weapons attacks, and a park and congress center. Number 3, Louvre Palace. The Louvre is a former royal palace located on the right bank of the Seine in Paris. Originally a fortress built in the medieval period, it became a royal palace in the 14th century under Charles V and was used time to time by the kings of France as their main Paris residence. In 1793, part of the Louvre became a public museum, which has expanded to occupy most of the building. The present-day Louvre Palace is a vast complex of wings and pavilions on 4 levels. 50,000 square meters of the palace complex are devoted just to public exhibition floor space. The royal residence of the kings of France for over 300 years, the modern-day Louvre Museum exhibitions occupy up over 60,000 square meters now. The entire palace complex occupies 40 hectares, or about 400,000 square meters. Number 2, Hofburg Palace. Former imperial palace in the center of Vienna, part of the palace forms the official residence and workplace of the President of Austria. Built in the 13th century and expanded in the centuries since, the palace has housed some of the most powerful people in European and Austrian history, including monarchs of the Habsburg dynasty, the rulers of the Austro-Hungarian Empire. It was the principal imperial winter residence and has over 2,600 rooms, coming in at, by itself, one building, 240,000 square meters. And number one, the Palace of Parliament. The Palace of the Parliament is the world's largest administrative building. For civilian use, the Pentagon is technically larger. It has 1,100 rooms and is 12 stories tall, with an additional 8 underground levels. The palace was intended to be used by the sovereign Nicolae Cescu, Romania's supreme ruler and dictator. The colossal parliament building is known for its ornate interior, and it is now housing the Senate and the Chamber of Deputies, 3 museums, and an international conference center. The National Museum of Contemporary Art, the Museum of Totalitarianism and Socialist Realism, and the Museum of the Palace are hosted inside the palace. And this whole palace comes in at 330,000 square meters. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did like the video, please give it a like down below. And if you want to see more content, please subscribe. What's your favorite palace? Pancake Palace. I hope you guys are having a great day. Bye-bye.